Hey, I did that without knowing her name, Jack. Okay, context. This is Clint with a famous 3D channel on YouTube with over 1 million followers named The Punisher, where he sometimes hosts
3D Community Challenge! Challenge!
The last one was in August, the boss fight challenge. The rules are simple. You have a demo scene with a camera that you can't move. You just have to replace the character in the scene with yours and make an environment with a sense of slow motion in your render. I wanted to do a scene inspired by the movie The Ritual. I really like the mood of this movie. Did you see it? At that time, I was working full time with the video creation and I thought, why not doing the software I don't know at all? Dumb idea. Although I didn't triumph at all in the challenge, the journey taught me Unreal for cinematics in just 3 weeks. As someone working with more traditional 3D software for VFX, it totally changed my way of doing 3D art. Here are the topics I will be covering for the curious, but I'm warning you, it will go fast. So, I heard you want to be a 3D artist, but it requires money for school, software, and skills? Now, let me find you an alternative. So, Unreal. You go to the Epic Store, download a blank scene from the theme panel. The first thing different from my usual workflow is that you are creating levels. In one scene, you can have multiple levels, and in my head, I compare them to different worlds or sequence. To save all levels, instead of Ctrl+S, do a Ctrl+Shift+S. I don't feel lost here, except for the content browser that just reads all the content in your project. Everything else looks like any 3D software with an outliner, parameters, and the viewport, of course. Even the navigation allows you to be classic. Alt left click to do a rotate, Alt right click to zoom, Alt middle click to pan. And if you want the same pan as in Maya, for example, go to Editor, Preferences, Viewport, Invert, Middle Mouse Pan. My first concern was understanding exactly how the scene render and how can I make big scene while still being able to render real time. So the default view is lit, used to display the final result of your scene and incorporating all the applied material and lighting. It is different from the rendering engine I usually use. They are usually pass tracer for me, which is also a feature of Unreal. So basically what it means, it calculate the global illumination in a scene by tracing the path of many light rays as they bounce into the environment. Knowing that, how can I make big and highly detailed scene renderable in lit mode? I did my research on Nanite first. They are Unreal Engine 5 virtualized geometry system which uses a new internal mesh format to render pixel scale, detail, and high object count. Okay, skip the explanation. In simple words, it killed the vertices and it allow a crazy shit amount of details. To convert the mesh to Nanite, you can right-click on your asset in the content browser, Nanite, enable. That's it. So the first thing I need is a ground. I'm going into landscape mode. Create new, you can fill the entire world if needed, but for our example, we don't need that. From here, we can use the tools to create deformation. I'm using the sculpt tool to make a bit of relief and the erosion tool to simulate erosion from soil and rainfall. And finally, the smooth tool, if needed, to polish everything. The challenging step for me now is the character creation. I'm a professional environment artist, not at all a character one. So this part is a bit of video I used to trick. The first one is I made custom metahumans from a scan of my face. I will show you this step by step in another video because I find it interesting. Here is another example of that. That way I have a rig I can animate and a proper shading with it. Okay, for the second character, the boss one, in the movie The Ritual, there is a huge beast called Mother. Moder, I don't fucking know. And I didn't have the time to sculpt that. So I found a model on Sketchfab with a broken rig. I imported the model into Maya, where I created the rig, painted the skin weight for it, and I did my animation as well. And after that, I had to retarget the animation from Maya to Unreal Engine. This was a very technical, dense process, and I will detail all that maybe. Not sure about this one, in another video as well. For the realistic environment, it's where Unreal shine because with Megascan we have high quality asset that I use with custom shader. Even more interesting are the mega scan trees, coming with wind simulation directly. And I also created custom trees in SpeedTrees and unique asset in Maya to bring diversity to the scene. Time now for the shading part. We can make them procedural or from texture. For this project, I used Substance Painter to create texture and then brought them into Unreal Engine to build my shader. Two important things here to create a material. Right click in the content browser, create material. This is where you will see all the node structure. I made things super simple. Basically, it's just an import of color, normal and specular roughness with a texture sample node. But I want to be able to control some of the parameter without having to dive into the material every time. For that, you need to add parameters that you can control in a material instance node. A copied one already made from a Megascan shader, dive into it and you can see, for example, here a vector parameter controlling saturation, brightness and contrast with mathematical operation. We just need our instance material now. For that, right click material, material instance. In the parent, select your normal material. And as you can see now, I can tweak the parameters. It's also in real time, and I have nothing else to do with it. Finally, for the ground, I used blend material. For that, you go on Quicksil Bridge, and just by selecting this icon and putting it on the side, select two or three material that you download or made. And here you can click on create material. You can assign material to a mesh with a drag and drop. Then you can change to mesh paint by selecting red. You will be able to paint the middle material and with the green, the top one. We just need lights now. So for that I'm using the Envlight mixer, which let us bring the directional light, which is the sun, the sky atmosphere, and I am adding different spotlight to highlight some of the model depending on the composition. For that misty forest by night look, exponential fog is your tool. I'm just checking volumetric fog, and then with this slider I can have more or less fog. The final touches are made in the post-processing instance. You can adjust color, contrast and more to get that cinematic look. I'm increasing the ray tracing, reflection max bounces and removing the auto exposure. And here is the drama. You see, with the render engine I'm usually using, which are either CPU or XPU based, if your scene is not optimized, it will render. It will just be extremely slow. I didn't plan that in Unreal Engine, which is GPU based, if your scene is too big, it just crash. And I got a lot of GPU timeouts. To correct that, I used an extreme solution on FN Online, which is this console command that set whether to enable or disable the GPU timing out. You will have to use it with extreme caution, as it can cause your PC to freeze. Also, as it was my first project, I really messed up with the render settings. As you can see, even for the final, there is a lot of artifact on the screen. And it's later, when I did a second project, this one, that I actually find the best render setting I could find for Unreal Engine. I will let you copy them in the description if you want to. And feel free to add in commentary if you have any magic command ideas. I will take them with pleasure. I'm not totally happy about it, to be honest. I found it like a failure. At the end, I was able to learn Unreal Engine, and for that I'm really grateful. And I wish I can do a video about that, you know, like this feeling of artist failure. I find it interesting. That was intense, right? So let me know about the video. And in any cases, do not worry. With hard work and dedication, you will find success in your passion, regardless of natural talent or expensive degrees. So stay f***ing motivated.